Hapon, good afternoon, and welcome to our Mindanao Dream. Today we're going to talk about bringing your pet over here from the States, just in case there's some of you out there that might be interested in doing that, and we'll give you our impressions on our experience on bringing an animal over here. The process was difficult at times, sometimes frustrating, but in the end it was worth it. There was first trying to find a company or a person that does that was hard. Luckily, through Delta Airlines, we found on their website they had a link to services for sending your dog abroad and or overseas. So we did through them and found a company called Dog Gone Taxi, and out of Seattle, Washington, and we got used them. They had a couple different options. If they did everything, it costed like about $1,400. I mean, that meant paperwork, picking the dog up, taking it to the vet, taking it to the airport, and getting it on the plane. We chose the lesser and had them just do the paperwork as far as the import permit for the Philippines and what type of permits and stuff that or what type of vaccinations would be required on our part, what certificates would be required on our part, and that only costed us $425. So, requirements for bringing your dog over to the Philippines from the States. One of them, major requirements, is a USDA certificate that you can only get 10 days before you're actually leaving the States for here. That costed $215. There was also vaccinations that had to be updated: distemper, hepatitis, parainfluenza, parvo, and then make sure that his rabies shots are up to date. I don't know exactly how much all that costed us, but all certificates, the Dog on Taxi took care of all import permits. So, as far as the cost of the vet and all that stuff, that's going to vary depending on your area, or just talking about for what it costed us. One other thing is the vet that you use has to be USDA certified to be able to send the, because he has to send a letter with all the rabies, all the vaccination information, health records to Spokane, where the USDA office is, to get their certificate that looks like this. So, another thing that it will be required, your animal will have to have a microchip installed in it. It doesn't matter the cost, because like I said, in your area it could be different than what it costed us. Let me see. Okay. I don't remember if I mentioned it earlier, but like I said, it costed us $200 for him to have a seat in the cargo. He had to endure about 17 hours of cargo time, so he was a pretty good trooper when it came to that. We talked about getting the landing permit when we got to Cebu, picked up picked up Pogi at the baggage claim area and took him over with all the information that was on his carrier. The lady at the landing, at the quarantine area, filled out the landing permit, cost us about 150 pesos, and then Perl was able to just take him as another piece of baggage out of the airport. The next day they went to the port in Cebu, cost about 25 pesos for his spot on the ship, but the permit for it, the shipping permit, was at no cost. So the reason why we had to do the ferry was because PAL and Cebu Pacific wouldn't fly a pet from Cebu to Mindanao or from Manila to Mindanao, and a ferry was a shorter ferry ride from Cebu, so she flew straight from Oregon through Japan. She threw through Narita to Cebu. Let me see. Our final destination was here in Mindanao. So I forgot to mention who we actually went with for our carrier, or what airline we used. Delta and Cathay Pacific and a lot of the other major international flights had restrictions on what time of the year that they would fly or transport dogs like Pogi, who's a Shih Tzu, because they consider it a snub-nosed dog. And I think it's between May and September they won't fly those dogs because of respiration issues. But Korean Airline had no such restriction. Korean Air is the airline that we end up going with due to the fact that they had no restrictions on flight time for animals. And it was nice also because Korean Air flew from Seattle to Cebu, which was a better fit for us. Korean Airline is the one we used. We've used them a couple times, and they're really good. For total cost to bring the dog over here to the Philippines from the U.S. costed us approximately $1,036. Approximately 200 for his place on the plane, 425 for the services from Doggone Taxi, 56 for his chip, $215 for the USDA certificate, and $138 for vet update and vaccinations, and UPS or DHL, whichever, I can't remember who used Fed Express, for the documents to go to Spokane and back within that 10-day period. That's, if anything else, the most important thing is to know is that the USDA certificate have a USDA certified vet and get a USDA certification for your pet within 10 days of you leaving. And was it worth it? Yeah, it was. Would I do it again? Yeah, I don't know. Perl says yes, we would. So I guess we would do it again. But this is Pogi's final resting spot. He's not going anywhere else. He's staying here in the Philippines, and so are we. Thanks for watching. Like, share, subscribe. Shout out to the Dodgers. Yeah, we're going back to the playoffs again. Hopefully this year we'll, third time's a charm, we'll win the series. Salamat. God bless.